2, 3. Oh my god.
김밥 열풍에 이어 K볶음밥이 미국을 강타하고 있습니다. 미국 대형마트에서 냉동김밥만큼이나 냉동볶음밥의 인기가 뜨겁다고 하는데요. CJ제일제당은 미국 냉동식품 선두기업인 슈안스를 인수해 미 전역 콜드체인 유통 시스템을 확보한 이후 한국형 냉동볶음밥을 현지에서 생산하고 있죠. 치킨, 채소, 새우 등 미국에서 가장 대중적인 볶음밥에 김치, 고추장, 마늘 등 한국식 맛을 더해 큰 인기를 끌고 있습니다. 미국 유명 요리방송 진행자로 활동 중인 스테파니 한세는 매달 가장 핫한 레스토랑 현장에 찾아가 그 음식을 먹어보고 배우는 프로그램을 진행 중인데요. 현재 가장 인기 있는 김치 볶음밥을 배우기 위해 한국계 셰프인 엔킴의 식당을 찾아갑니다. 엔킴 셰프는 김치 피자 하나로 미국 요식업계의 오스카상으로 불리는 제임스 비어드상을 수상한 현재 미국에서 가장 주목받는 셰프 중 한 명입니다.
We happen to be standing in your newest restaurant called Kim's.
Yes. This past November, I just decided to reconcept to something a little more personal, close to my heart and something I grew up with, and that's Korean-American cuisine. And I have a talented crew, and they get creative, and we collaborate and come up with things that just, at the end of the day, taste good.
Yeah.
Feel good to me.
Because it is super tasty, and taste buds, we are here to have some super tasty. We're gonna make your famous fried rice.
Yeah, we're gonna make spam and kimchi fried rice, and we can't really call it spam. We're
yes.
calling it Ann's ham.
Ann's ham.
Yes, we call it Ann's ham because we make it in-house,
yes.
inspired by spam.
Sure, what an homage.
And then the kimchi is my mother's recipe, family recipe, and it's been the same ever since, and toss that in and make something really delicious.
All right, I can't wait to see your version and taste your version of Spam, Ann's ham, we'll call it. I'll stop calling it spam. We'll just call it Ann's ham.
Ann's ham.
We're making fried rice with Ann Kim.
So I added here some smoked onions, and we smoke it because I love the kind of rich, deep flavor of that. Then we have the Ann's ham that we've cubed
yeah.
up, and we're going to get a little color on that.
So we're going to get a lot of good crispy bits.
That's the best part.
I think so, too.
We are going to add white short grain Korean rice, as well as some people call it forbidden rice. Some
yeah.
people call it black rice. And we have to make this ahead of time because you want it to be dried out. You never want to use like fresh rice because it'll stick all over the place.
Which is why if you get takeout, always save your rice in the freezer because it makes excellent fried rice.
That's right. Rice is life, as I say. And then a little bit of butter because we're in the Midwest.
Butter tastes good.
It gives it kind of a richness. And when people ask like, ooh, where's that from? It's butter. And then gonna add the kimchi. Kimchi just means pickle in Korean. So there's probably hundreds of varieties of fermented vegetables. And we add pickled Fresno because I like the addition of a little more heat. And we pickle it so it's a little sweet and a little spicy. And now we're going to add the rice.
You are taking all of those ingredients and all those components and putting an Ann Kim twist on it, which I guess is probably why you're an amazing chef.
And
I have to say, I did tell her this already, cleanest restaurant kitchen I've ever been in. Your kitchen's probably cleaner than my home kitchen, which is saying a lot.
Now we're going to add a little secret sauce, which is our house-made chojang. And chojang is sort of a sweet and sour spicy sauce. It's basically made out of gochujang, which is a fermented chili paste.
Yep.
And you'll find gochujang in so many different things.
For this same episode, after this, we're going to shop with our friend Casey Kai, who makes a version of that that he calls the Korean ketchup. So he would reiterate that Koreans use this in all their food.
They do. So now the flavors are all
so beautiful.
Melded together. And now I'm going to finish with a little bit of scallion in there.
Something green. You always want to finish with green.
So now we're going to turn around.
You got the flair. My husband taught me how to do that, but I'm not as good at it as you are. Okay.
Okay.
I can smell like delicious sizzling pork nugget and pepper.
Pork nugget. I like that.
Yeah. Just like, oh, like kind of how bacon smells.
We're not done quite yet. We've got some toasted sesame seeds, which adds a nuttiness. We also make in-house fried ginger.
Yum.
And adds another level of dimension. And then this,
that's pretty amazing.
So this is the finished product. This is our kimchi fried rice with Ann's ham. And remember I told you rice is life?
Like, yes.
If there isn't rice at the Korean table, then you're not eating. And the way people ask if you're doing well, like my mother as a term of endearment, the first thing she'll say when she calls me is 밥 먹었나? And that means, have you eaten?
Oh.
And that just means, are you doing good? And when you say, let's eat, it's basically, let's eat 밥. 밥 means to eat, but it's a literally, 밥 means rice.
Oh.
So this is a big deal.
If I just start,
go,
I have
please.
To lift up my bowl so I can get the smell in my face. Oh, look at that. This is delicious. I can definitely taste the nuttiness of the rice that we use, the combination. Also, it's spicy, mm-hmm. but it's not burning. It's just flavorful spicy. Does that make sense?
It
I need to find better
does.
Words.
Yeah.
But
it's got a kick to it, for
this
sure.
This is kind of a whole warming mouth experience.
Oh, good. I mm-hmm. like that. Warm.
Mm. You eat rice every day, you think? Because I feel like if I was eating this, I would.
Growing up, there was rice at every meal, but now it's like, I have 4 restaurants. I often eat at the restaurant, but when my parents come over, there's usually always rice on the table.
요즘 미국 가정에서 한식 한두 개쯤 만드는 건 필수죠. 스테파니 역시 집에 가서 김치 볶음밥을 복습해 봅니다.
I'm gonna cut it into cubes, very similar to how Anne did at Kim's. I'm gonna use some of my kimchi. I'm gonna use about 1/4 cup. I was afraid of kimchi for a while. I don't know why, just probably because I wasn't a very adventurous eater. I would highly encourage you though to try it now. My kid loves it, my husband loves it. We're gonna add the K-Mama sauce. This is a spicy version, so this is not going to be for the faint at heart. I've got 1 cup of rice. And again, I think this will make a portion for like 2 maybe. I'm also at this point gonna throw in jalapenos. All right, I think everything is feeling good. Now, when we were at Kim's, they had like crispy bits to put on top. I have scallions, which are a little boring, but it'll give it a little bit of green. I have some of the pickled jalapeno, and then I'm gonna just hit it with a tiny bit of salt. Mmm. The thing I love about Korean food, your whole mouth warms up. All the flavors are blending.
스테파니는 김스 식당에서 김치 볶음밥보다 파전이 더 인상 깊었다고 하는데요. 제대로 따라 만들 수 있을까요?
I'm supposed to lay my scallions down and create a mat. This is my chefy way. I'm gonna go ahead and pour some of my batter in, crossing my fingers. Let's go scallion pancakes. They're kind of moving around a little bit. I see bubbles. Oh, it's solid. See it? It's kind of loose in there. I could do the Ann Kim strategy, but I feel like I'm really risking. Come on, come on, come on. Okay, ready? Oh, crepe. Burr. Okay, we're gonna have to do one more. Putting my scallions down in a mat. Okay, and now my pan is really hot. Here we go. I'm doing it just a little bit thinner batter. And I think this could be the ultimate scallion pancake. So I'm gonna try doing it the Ann Kim way. I just need to be brave and really get a good flip. Okay, ready? Oh, so close! Dang it! Do we do one more? Spray, we've got our little scallion raft, our batter. This one doesn't work, friends. I'm calling it quits. You know who can flip really good too is Kurt. Kurt, do you feel like you could flip a pancake for me? Okay, you ready? You can't wear that hat, it's too gross. Okay, everybody, this is Kurt Johnson, my husband. We've called in reinforcements. We're gonna wait till it's ready, and then you're gonna give it the real Kurt Johnson flip. Because I really probably should have done it on like a flat top so that I could just flip it with a skillet. No, 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 it's not ready yet. Oh, this is why we do not cook together. You're looking for like
ready.
The little bubbled up.
Opens up.
Okay, so are you feeling ready, Kurt?
I am ready.
Wait, are you sure it's done?
Oh yeah, it's done. Are you ready?
Oh.
1, 2, 3. Oh my God.
I'm so mad that you got it so good the first time. Thank you, Kurt. Okay.
He did work in a restaurant. I was just a cocktail waitress. I'm gonna try one more time. Oh, I got it! I got it! Did you see it? Ooh, okay. It's about like you really gotta get aggressive with the wrist. Holy cats, that was fun. There's a scallion pancake. Mm. Oh, yum. It's very much like a starchy pancake, like kind of a cross between maybe how an omelet texture would be. Very good. The scallion wrapped, I think, is important. Because I think if you didn't have that, you wouldn't have enough flavor. Yum. Try the scallion pancakes, friends. You're gonna like it.
이제 한국 음식은 미국 어디서나 손쉽게 접할 수 있는 가장 맛있고 편안한 음식으로 자리 잡았습니다. 더 다양한 음식들을 접해보길 바라며 오늘 준비한 소식 마치겠습니다. 여러분의 소중한 의견을 남겨주세요. 바쁘시더라도 구독과 좋아요 부탁드립니다. 지금까지 단골이시였습니다. 시청해주셔서 감사합니다.